Hi, Santa Cruz. Welcome back to A Beautiful Life. I am Mariah Fay. I want to give special recognition to Randy Pizer, author One Stop. Randy has been a guest on my show twice, and her book, Crappy to Happy, was shown on Eat, Pray, and Love, the Julia Roberts Show. So congratulations, Randy. We're proud of you. Tonight, I have a very special guest with me, a magnificent pain healer, Paul Barbaro. Paul is truly gifted, and I know this because he worked on me. I had excessive pain for a year and a half from a leg injury, and he worked on me one time, and the pain went away, and for the first time that night in a year and a half, I was actually able to go to sleep without dealing with the pain. He is very, very gifted, and he'll tell you how he received these gifts that he's going to demonstrate tonight. And we have a studio audience. Thank you so much for being here. So here is Paul. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, too.
It's all yours.
Okay. Hi. I wrote a book called Heal That Pain Now. And it's the culmination of 30 years of research. And I am an energy researcher. For 30 years, I pursued why hands-on healing works. 2,000 years ago, if a person got sick, they went to the village square, and the people in the square would put their hands on them for about a half an hour, and they would be fine, and they'd go back home, and they would be healthy. And I studied this and studied this. I wanted to know why it works. So 30 years later, I run into two Indian shamans, and they said, when you study Eastern medicine, they teach you about meridians, they teach you about chakras, they teach you about acupressure and acupuncture points and all these different things. And this makes it very complex. Sometimes the charts were even in different languages that I couldn't understand. And so what I did is I had to make the subject simple. Ran into two Indian shamans about 2 years ago, and I asked them, what are the important points amid all these all this information on energy centers in the body? And they said there's 6 hot spots on the entire body. You can ignore all the other spots as long as you focus on these 6 hot spots. So in my book, I put the 6 hot spots on the body, and I will demonstrate them for you. The hottest spot is the forehead. It's not necessarily the pineal, the hypothalamus, and the pituitary gland, but it's the entire forehead. Hot means the energy is so present that when you touch it, or when someone else touches it, the pain is just ready to jump out of your body and go into the atmosphere, go into the ether. So the forehead is the hottest spot. The heart on the front and the heart on the back is the second hot spot. And then the dantian, which is just below the belly button, it's an energy center of the body. And the sacrum, which is the hard bone at the base of the spine that goes into the pelvis, it actually joins the spine to the pelvis. Those are the hottest spots on the body, and then the occipital is number 1 on the back. So I call it healing 1-2-3 is my method. It's 1 forehead, 2 heart, 3 dantian, and on the back it's 1 occipital, which is the bone right here at the base of the ear. If you find your ear and just press inward, you'll feel the base of the skull, and it's just right there, but it runs across the back of the head, so you actually could span it with both fingers. You can span the occipital, because the entire base of the skull is the occipital, and then the back heart, and then the sacrum. And the technique is your hands are like a jumper cable. Okay, this is basic. When there's trauma to the body, when you're a child, really early, when there's trauma to your body, the cells take a picture. All right, here's how pain works. This is new information. When you're a kid, you get hurt. It goes like that. You get hurt. When there's trauma to the body, the cells take a picture of the pain, and it holds a picture. So as a kid, you brush yourself off and say, I'm fine. But the picture is still there, and it has energy to it, and there's a lot of cells, and there's a lot of pictures. And it works just like a battery. I'm going to introduce you to Max. Max is my prop. And I'm going to connect one of these to Max and the other one to the other side. And this is how the cells work. Now, in a battery, they call them cells also. It's a series of little plates in there. And each one puts out a little tiny bit of voltage. But when you put it all together, it makes a big spark. And this is exactly how pain works in the body. You got the earliest pain, you got later pain, later pain, later pain, and right to the present pain. My technique works on the earlier pain, and it discharges the engine that creates the pain that you're having now. And when the battery is dead, it gets rid of the pain up here. And it's nice to have the theory, and it's nice to have Max. Watch Max. See that? There's energy there. Now watch, Max. Max has a belief system. I believe I'm the president. Didn't handle the pain. I believe I'm the queen. I believe I'm the pope. I believe I'm the rabbi. Okay, I had 10 years of psychotherapy. I spent $150,000. Didn't take care of the early pain. See down here, early pain? I've had 8 surgeries on my leg. And my doctor scheduled me for the 9th surgery because I still have pain in my leg. Notice, that didn't take care of the earliest pain. And when the doctor makes a cut, it puts more energy in there, which means, and after nine surgeries, he hasn't gotten the fact that it's not working for him. And what he doesn't need is more pain added to the pain. Max. Okay. So what you're going to see is a demonstration where I'm going to get rid of this part of the pain in a person, and it will handle pain up here. In other words, it's a nice theory until I show it. So I'm going to call somebody out of the audience. Okay, pain level of 8 or higher? 8? Okay, great. I'm going to take Julia first because she has a 6 o'clock. She's got an appointment and she's got to get going. But come on up, Julia. And let me have you get on the table from this side because this side's higher. No. Oh, you know what I have to do? I have to face the camera first so they see what you look like. And I'm going to take a picture of you because part of the process is taking a picture of the person. Because we take before and after pictures because she will never look like this again. Because when the pain is resolved, the face changes. And the proof of the pudding is in the face. Okay? So I'm going to take your picture real quick. Is it okay? Okay. Boy, this is a slow camera. Come on. I have to deal with the technical things here. Just waiting for it to come around. Hang on here for a second. There you go. Look at you. Look at you. And I'm going to take one more just in case. And there you go. Thank you. I'll put the camera down and go ahead and lay down on the table. Head here or the other way.
On
your back first, yeah.
Shoes off.
Yeah, I'll take your shoes off real quick here. Or here, I'll work on the other one just to save time. Here we go. And let me get that off. Socks are okay, but the shoes are not. Yeah, I should have had you take them off or loosen them a little bit earlier. Okay, great. Here we go. All right. Now, what I'm going to do is there's 6 hot spots on the body, the forehead, the heart, and the dantian. So I'm going to put one on the dantian and one on the forehead. And I call it healing 1-2-3. It's a new method. And what I'm doing is I'm also going to do the governing vessel number 1 and number 2. You don't need to remember governing vessel. That's advanced technique. But all I'm doing is completing a circuit. Just like the jumper cable completed the circuit on Max, I'm completing the circuit on her body, and her head is getting very hot. Once you've done this on, say, maybe 6 or 10 people, your hands get very intuitive. I say there's little tiny eyes at the tips of your fingers, and you get very, very intuitive about it, and you can actually feel the pain. Her head was a little bit cool when I first put my hand on her, and now it's very, very hot. I've actually had like 5 degrees of difference in temperature between, say, the head and the tummy. And that proves this theory. By the way, it was the United States Army that did the research on pain memory in the cells. They did it in 1955. They did all years and years and years and years of medical experiments with cells and pain. They'd actually take cells out of a person's body, put it in a Petri dish, and then they sent it to Phoenix, and they had the guy here in Los Angeles. And what they did is they delivered pain to the cells in Los Angeles, and the cells in Phoenix responded in the Petri dish. They were not only physically connected, physically, but they were also spiritually connected, and they repeated the experiment and repeated the experiment, repeated it again and again and again. And guys like Bruce Lipton and a few others really have promoted this concept. And when doctors call me and say, Paul, what do you got? I work on physicians. Doctors will come, medical doctors, AMA card carrying doctors will come to me and say, Paul, fix me. And I'll say, Doc, you got every pill on the planet. You know, heal thyself, you know, like the Hippocratic Oath. And they say, Paul, fix me. And I'll say, Doc, what do you know about energy? And I'll teach them this stuff. I'll say, you just got to discharge those circuits in the body. Two hands on the body, just like two jumpers on the on Max. Two hands on the body, and all I'm doing, and the head is cooling down a little bit. Her tummy is warming up. What'll happen is one will get warm, the other will get cool, and it'll go back and forth on about a 5 or a 10 minute cycle, and it'll go back hot and cold, hotter and cooler. It's not real hot, it's not real cold, but some people have been so hot I had to go like that, because I could not put my hand on them. And I know healers that have quit healing, and they said the reason why they quit healing is because their hands get so hot. And I'm saying, it's not your energy, it's their energy. And they're so hot, and you quit healing because you think you're doing harm to them when all this energy is releasing. So if she gets too hot, I'll just go like that and the head is cooling off quite a bit now. And I can do heart also. On the ladies, you have to be careful, but the sternum is right here. It's the entire sternum covers the entire heart. So I'll go for the sternum here. And you know, you'd be respectful of your client. And you're just nice. And the heart is hot also. The heart is very hot. And sometimes I'll ask the client, you know, what's going on with your heart? Or if the head is really super hot, I'll say, what are you worried about? You know, what's going on in your head? And they say, oh, I don't have my rent money this month. And I'm saying, well, what do you got to do to fix that? You know, because I want them not to be worried about their life. This is almost like a meditation. And I want them to be more in a meditative state. I sometimes, when I'm at my house, I'll work out in the backyard with the birds and the squirrels and other things out there, and where my feet can be on the ground barefoot, you know, really grounded out to the ground. And I love it out there because there's big trees and there's, you know, critters and things, an occasional cat. And I work, okay, now she's smoothing out really nicely here, really nicely here. All I'm doing is completing circuits. You can turn on a non-shoot 'em up TV show, something informational, something PBS, to keep your mind occupied, because it can get down right now. I'm going to wipe off some of the extra energy, because when I'm working here, it'll scare up other energies, and you just wipe it down like that, and you wipe it, and just smooth her out, and she's doing marvelously here, marvelously. All I'm doing is completing circuits. It's just like Max, discharging those cells. When the cells are reset to zero, the key is when there's trauma to the body, there's no clear button, there's no reset button. Just because you get up and you brush yourself off and say that no problem, doesn't mean all that energy is still not there. You'll even have dreams about that energy. You know, I still dream about the time I fell out of the orange tree in our yard, because I was up there getting oranges and I fell out of the tree. I still dream about that. Every once in a while, times I fell off the bike, ran into a tree, ran into a telephone pole on the bike. I didn't see the pole. You know, I was looking somewhere else and ran smack right into the pole. All that energy is still there. You can actually get a galvanometer, like an ohm meter, and it'll actually register when you say recall that pain. It'll actually show up. They've actually done pain experiments on plants too, where they take tomato plants and they put ohm meters on them, and then they'd have someone who was mean to plants and someone who was nice to plants walk into the room, and when the mean person walked into the room, it would show up on the meter. And I mean, these are real experiments of cellular recordings of pain after the fact, you know? So
Okay, now here's what we're going to do, little lady. We're going to roll you over, Julia, and work on your other side. The energy was even, very, very even from the head, the heart, and to the Don Tian. So I'll work on her back, and it's fun to work on the back side. Is this in your way? Let me get rid of this and put it under your feet here. Yes, thank you. And here's what, we're going to scoot you this way about 4 inches. Okay, there you go. Thank you. Okay, now, on the back, you can be a little meaner to the person on the back because the sacrum's rather hard. So, and all I'm doing is completing circuits. This goes here. This goes here. It's okay to tingle, it's okay to go to sleep, and it's okay to purr in that sequence. People have gone to sleep on me. And usually it takes about 10 minutes into the process before they just really just let go and let everything relax. And the sacrum is supposed to move. It's supposed to move this way, and then laterally like that. And this is just hard as a rock. I actually thought the sacrum was fused into the pelvis. But it actually is supposed to move when you bend. Otherwise, you couldn't bend over like that, and so this is hard as a rock. This is important because there's 8 major nerve channels that go to the digestive and reproductive tract, and there's also 8 major blood vessels, nerve channels, and immune channels that go through the sacrum into the lower part of the body, and some of them go down the legs to the feet. So this is. And people sit on the sacrum all day long and they ignore it. It's one of the most ignored parts of the body. The sacrum and the bottoms of the feet and the elbows are probably the most ignored parts of the body. And so the reason why I'm pounding is to loosen up the energy. It's really stuck. It's and I can say wake up, 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 and wake up the energy. Now, one thing I'm going to do with Julia is, with her permission, I'm going to ask her ancestors and her angels and her guides that are always with her, whether you believe in them or not, doesn't matter. Your opinion of the spiritual realm doesn't influence them at all. And I'm going to ask her angels, her ancestors, the ancestors that she wants to have help her. If she has ancestors she doesn't want to have help her, it's okay. And they get excluded. But I'm going to ask her angels and her guides to be part of her healing because they know better what she needs than I do. This information was given to me. I simply asked. 2 or 3 years ago, I had major, major best lifetime friends die on me. I mean, just, and I was powerless to help them, and I was an energy healer for 30 years. So I got a hold of my angels and guides, and I said, look, guys, I need something that works. What I'm doing isn't working. And I've been asking for a long time. You know, I'd lost sisters and brothers and aunts and uncles and best friends and just cancer and heart disease and everything under the sun. You name it, they died from it. And I couldn't help them, and I was a healer. And I said, look, I need something that works. And they said, I was working on this lady maybe 2 years ago, and just like this on the table, And I was doing all this, you know, this massage and this other stuff. And they said, put one hand on the sacrum. And I'd been working on it for about 20 minutes. I put one hand on her sacrum here, and I put the other one on the occipital. And there was a spark. And I said, okay, guys, where did that spark come from? And they said, early childhood pain of long duration. Now, the oldest person I've ever worked on is 86 years, okay? And I like working on seniors because they have so many years of trauma. And I mean, they take so much. These guys are really walking saints because they've made it to that age with those kind of odds against them. And it's humbling to work on them. But when I put my hands on them, all that original energy is still there. Anyway, I got a spark off this lady. So I asked my angels, where did that spark come from? Because it takes 3,000 volts to make a spark. And they said, pain from a long time ago. And I said, now wait a minute, these people have been in and out of healers for the past 10 years and doctors and chiropractors and everything else under the sun. I said, you mean that pain has never been addressed? And they said they never even got close. So that's not the punchline. The punchline is the lady got up from the table and I did not recognize her face. She'd lost 20 years in 20 minutes. And I said, okay, guys, you got to tell me what this is, because I have never in my life, in 30 years of doing healing work, I never got a result like that. And they said, all you did was discharge, and basically it was this right here. It was just this right here, you know. And so I wasn't that impressed with it, except I saw her 6 months later, and the recording of the pain in the face never came back. And I said, okay, I know that this is long-lasting now. I can't use the word permanent, but I can use the word long-lasting. And I said, okay, guys, what do I do with this? And they said, you got to put it in a book and get this stuff out there. And I said, well, the last thing the world needs is another book on healing. And they said, they don't have this stuff. So when I put together my little six hot spots, when I train this, I give classes in this, when I teach about the six hot spots, the forehead, heart, dantian, sacrum, heart in the back, her heart needs a lot of work here. A lot of work, a lot of energy in the heart. Sometimes you're just holding a memory there. You're just, and you don't want to let go. Sometimes a person just has to forgive. They simply have to forgive. You just say, whoever I don't know who's in your past, but whoever it is, you got to forgive them. And they'll say, well, I can forgive everybody except that one SOB. And I'll say, is it worth staying sick by holding that kind of grudge, because the only person that's killing is you? And they'll have something like cancer or things going on in the gut. And I'll say, you got to let it go, because you got to let it go because it's not doing you any good. And either you're going to let it go and you're going to get healthy, or you're not going to let it go and it's going to kill you. I mean, that's what it comes down to. And it's your choice. It's your call. And you can hang on to that if you want. I mean, it's a free country, basically. And see, the reason why I'm getting a bit tougher with this lady is I want to, you know, move the energy a little bit quicker. So, I usually tell my people that I like to pound on them hard enough to where I can feel it in my feet on the floor. And of course, she'll say something if it's too hard. So, she'll say something. She will definitely say something. Huh. Always too. Now, since I'm going to have you raise both your feet up, because it's not, the energy isn't moving. So what I'm going to do is grab her feet and her crown chakra up here, or maybe forehead. Forehead, and see, the head just got hotter. Magic, how it works. Just magic. You know, you touch a spot and it's cool, and then it's almost like you turned on the stove and it just gets instantly red hot, and it's like, wow. And you do whatever it takes to get rid of the, you know, and you ask the angels, what do I got to do to get rid of this energy? Huge amounts. It's amazing what the body can hold. You know, it's like a recording device that can hold 300 songs or something like that. I hate to liken it to a device that plays music, but it's almost like a 30 gig hard drive, because it records the memory, and it just, now this is a defense mechanism. The cells remember the pain because they want to keep you safe in the future, so you don't get into that situation again. So it's a defense mechanism. There's just no reset button on it. And, you know, that probably served us for eons. It's just, it doesn't serve us now, not in this modern age where performance really counts. Okay, so the energy's moving a little bit here. And check the heart. Heart's a little bit cooler. Oh, Julie. Oh, okay, go ahead. How do you feel?
Just fine,
okay. Okay. I like to check in with the people I'm working on, because it's really a treat. It's really, really, really a treat. I tell doctors that if they did this half an hour before the surgery and half an hour after the surgery, and they don't have to do it, they can have a nurse's aide or a student or little candy stripers. I don't know what they call them now, but the volunteers or the nurses that are students. I know a lot of the hospitals around here get students from Stanford and from San Jose State and all that. And have those people do it. You know, just keep the hands there. You know, 20 minutes, before the surgery and 20 minutes or a half an hour or an hour after surgery, and they'll heal three times quicker, and they'll stop getting sued, and they'll demand that you're the only one that works on them in the future if they ever need another surgery, and they'll bring their friends kicking and scratching and say, this is the only doctor that works on you because I said so, and I'm your friend. And if you don't have this doctor work on you, I'm not going to be your friend anymore. Sometimes that's what it takes to, and then you know, it's nice to get referrals instead of lawsuits. You know, what's that worth to a medical professional? I don't know. Well, you know, what's that worth? I don't know. So Julia's doing very well here. Okay, see, the energy's moving pretty good here. Okay, we're going to roll you over on the other side now, Julia. The reason why I turned her over is because it wasn't moving on the first side. I'm going to make sure the table doesn't tip here. You got to just move slowly. We got time. I can see her face is different already. Okay, I can be working on a person face up like this, and I can actually see in 5-minute increments, I can see the face change in front of me, but it never goes back to the way it looked like before. And some people, I'm downright sorry I didn't take pictures of them. The change was that great. Because, and then 2 years later, they never went back to that look again. And I wanted to get that on, but I have dozens of these pictures, and I look at them. I'll save them for about 6 months, and I'll look at them about 6 months later, and it's profound. That, you know, I'll put them side by side, and it's profound, the difference. There you are. Hi.
Hi.
Thank you for being so willing. I always thank my people. It is a humbling gift. It really is. The results go way beyond the technique. I'm basically connecting three points on the body in front and three points on the body and back. And that's all I'm doing. And just you know, see her head is getting hot again. Getting very warm. It wasn't warm to start with. It's just amazing to see what the energy does. There will be a point where it's all calm and it'll feel smooth. And there's actually a point where the energy system of the body clicks on, and I liken it to holding out your hands in the middle of the Mississippi River and trying to stop the water. The energy flow is that great, and there's a point where you can actually feel the body click on, and it's just amazing. It takes a lot of work. I never say it's going to be quick. I'm just saying the process is easy to do, and you simply have to have people you work with that are patient. And you simply work with them. You work on each other, you trade off. That's what I wrote the book for. You can read the book in 1 hour. You can do the process on a loved one in another hour, and you can get a result 2 hours from the time you started reading the book. You can actually put the book on their tummy here, open it up and read a page and do what it says. And I'm doing videos to train this also, so in case you're in Mississippi or somewhere and you're not, I'm not around, you can watch the video and simply lay a partner down and do it, or friend, and just work on them. And the message is, you don't have to be in pain any longer. You don't have to take it. And people call me and say, is this going to fix my brain cancer? Is this going to fix my heart disease? Is this going to fix my lymphoma? Sometimes they'll say it's going to fix the damage I did to my leg when I broke my leg in three different places. And I'm saying it doesn't fix structural damage that's already been done to the body. The best time to do it is before the fact, you know? And I'm sorry it can't, you know, put you back together again like that, but if the damage has already been done, it's not, you know, it's miraculous, but it's it can't really regenerate things. And people will call me and say, I've got cancer. You know, and I'll say, between the chemo treatments, get the energy work done by a spouse, a child, a loved one, anybody. Just, you know, get the book, get the work done. Come and see me if you have to. But do it between the treatments, because sometimes it'll go into remission and it'll stay in remission for several years, and then the disease will come back and it generally comes back with a greater and greater vengeance. So here's what, Julia, we're going to have you get up, and I want you to face the audience, and I want to take your picture again, and let's have you get up this way. Well, either way, I guess, but it's easier that way. And what I want to do is take a look at her face, and hopefully you notice there's a bit of a difference. And I want you to come on over here and take your picture again, second time. I know you might be a bit camera shy, but you know, oh, look at you. Look at you, my gosh. Okay, I'm gonna take your picture again. And another one, just for training's sake. I need to get a faster camera. Thank you. All right. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you so much. I can see the difference in your face sitting over there. Yeah.
Do you people see a difference in her face?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, Paul. Thank you.
Yes, yes, yes.
That is so exciting.
Mm-hmm.
Now,
really
this works for emotional pain, for childhood emotional pain too, correct? Not just physical.
Also, it not only works on emotional pain, it actually handles decisions you've made as a child based on pain avoidance, and it gets rid of that paradigm, and you start making good decisions in the workplace, because avoiding pain at the corporate level, let's say you're managing people or you're HR director or things like that, and all your decisions are based on pain avoidance, you can actually make
emotional
decisions that don't have anything to do with what's going on really in the workplace.
That
and when you
wonderful.
Do the work, you can sort through those decisions that you made as a child, because you don't have a lot of life experience when you're a kid,
right.
Especially if you're 3 or 4 or 5 years
right.
old. And then what happens is, I've actually had people get up off the table and say, I'm no longer depressed. And I said, I didn't even know you were depressed. I was just handling the pain.
That's wonderful.
But they will say that the wiring in the brain gets straightened out, and what will happen in Julia for like say 3 days is